For this lesson, you need to open the sample file Sales Report 4 from your Sample Files folder. You need to begin by making sure you're in Page Layout View. You'll remember from Lesson 7.2 that I can change views by using the three icons at the bottom right of the screen. The left icon will put me into Normal View, but I want Page Layout View. That's the center icon. When you're in Page Layout View, notice there's a header and a footer area at the top and bottom of each printed page. If you're printing a long report, it's very useful to add page numbers to the header of each page. So let's do that now by adding a page header that will show the page numbers at the top of each page. I click in the Click to Add Header section and notice that a Header and Footer Tools Design tab has appeared on the ribbon. So I'll click the Design tab and notice that at the left-hand side of the ribbon there's a Header and Footer group. I'll click Header and you can see many common items that you can add to the header of a page. These are called auto headers. I can see page 1 and that's exactly what I want. So I'll click on page 1 and you can see that page 1 appears at the top of the page. And if I scroll down to the second page, you can see that it says page 2 and the third page is headed with page 3. So my sequential numbering is working. As well as adding an auto header, I can also add an auto footer. I'm going to add an auto footer now to show the file name, that will be Sales Report 4, at the bottom of each page. So I click in the Click to Add Footer section and notice that once again the Header and Footer Tools Design tab has appeared on the ribbon. I click the Design tab and once again I need the Header and Footer group, but this time the footer icon. And I wanted to show Sales Report 4 at the bottom of this page. And I can see that there is an auto footer that says Sales Report 4. So I'll click it and Sales Report 4, the name of the file, is added to the footer area of the page. And you can see that it's also been added to the footer area of each printed page. It doesn't matter which page you add your header and footer to. You can add or edit header and footer information on any page, and it will then automatically apply to every other page. It's very common to print an Excel report and then collate it into another report, perhaps produced using Word. If the pages were to be inserted after page 9, we'd have a problem here because our page numbering begins at page 1. In this case, we'd want Excel to begin numbering at page 10. Here's how you can do that. I'll click Page Layout on the ribbon, and in the Page Setup group, I need to click the Dialog Launcher. That's a little arrow in the bottom right corner. I click the Dialog Launcher, and the Page Setup dialog appears with the Page tab already selected. And you can see that there's a First Page Number option here. At the moment, it's set to auto, meaning it will begin numbering at page 1. But I want to begin at page 10, so I click in the auto box and type 10 on the keyboard and then click the OK button. And you can see that page numbering now begins at page 10 and then follows on with page 11 and page 12 and so on to the end of the report. All that remains for this lesson is to save your work, and I'm going to save with the new name, Sales Report 5. And as usual, I save to the folder above my Sample Files folder. I click the Save button, and you've now completed Lesson 7.7. Add auto headers and auto footers, and set the starting page number.